With doubtnet, get instant video solutions to all your maths, physics, chemistry and biology doubts. Just click the image of the question, crop the question and get instant video solution. Download doubtnet app today.
Hello everyone. So in this question, it is given that which of the following compounds will be most easily attacked by an electrophile? So an electrophile, first you should know the meaning of an electrophile. So electrophile, that is E plus, is an electron deficient species. It will attack on that part where electron density is more. Therefore, remembering this theory, we can proceed with the option which is given to us. First, in the option we have nitrobenzene. So the nitrobenzene, what it will do is, the structure of nitrobenzene I will like in the expanded form. This is the structure of nitrobenzene. So nitrobenzene is an electron withdrawing group, so it will have minus m effect. So what it will do, this will withdraw electrons from benzene ring, and the structure after resonance would look like this. So once this double bond is shifting over here, so there is this positive charge which is created, and that becomes electron deficient. So this is making benzene electron deficient, that is electron density has been decreased. It will create a positive charge. Since it is positive charge, so electrophile, which is already electron deficient, cannot attack over here because they both will be electron deficient, and hence in this structure would be the last. Okay, so this structure, that is nitrobenzene, would be the last in the electrophilic attack. So next we have chlorobenzene. Chlorobenzene, if you see the structure for chlorobenzene, it is, this is your chlorobenzene. So chlorobenzene will have minus I effect, and minus I effect means it is an electron withdrawing group. Since Cl is an electronegative atom, so electron density in the ring decreases. So again, the priority, that is chlorine, is much more less electron withdrawing group comparatively to the nitro group. So it will be placed before nitrobenzene. Next option which we have is that of aniline. This is aniline and this is toluene. So I'll write the structures together, aniline and toluene. The aniline structure is NH2, this one. Okay, so what happens is, this will show plus R effect, that is nitrogen lone pair will come on this single bond, and this will move over here, which will give the resonance structure as creating a positive charge on nitrogen. Again, shifting can happen, which will give me the product as one more shifting can happen like this. So basically what is happening is, there is this increase in electron density, and electrophile will attack at that position where electron density is more. Therefore, NH2 will be the best amongst all these options which is given to us. So the plus R effect of NH2 is much more better, and therefore this will be the highest rate will be given by this aniline. That is, electrophilic substitution will be maximum in the case of aniline. So next product which we have is toluene. Again, this is the structure of toluene. This will show plus I effect and plus H effect. So basically, again, it is increasing electron density in the ring. Therefore, this will also show good rate of electrophilic E plus substitution. Therefore, but we know that the priority of resonance is more than plus H then plus I. So therefore resonance will be given first priority, and hence then aniline will have the highest rate. So if I try to write down the rate of electrophilic substitution reaction, it would be for first aniline, then it would be for toluene, then it will be for chlorobenzene, and finally it would be for nitrobenzene. So this will be the rate. If you see the options which is given to us, that is, which of the following compound will be most easily attacked by an electrophile? So it will be for aniline. Okay, thank you.
For class 6 to 12, ITJ and NEET level, trusted by more than 5 crore students. Download Doubt and App today.